Today we're going to talk about stand assessments. Stand assessments are a visual indicator of corn and soybean plants in a field or a field area. When we do stand assessments, we're looking at doing stand counts, assessing the uniformity of emergence, and then if the uniformity and the stand counts aren't what we expected, we want to go in and we want to investigate why they did not get to where we wanted them to be. There's five reasons that we want to do stand assessments. The first being is that we want to assess planter performance. So did we get too much or too little down pressure? Was the toolbar not even? Did we not have some driver gears in the right positions? The second reason is that we want to be able to assess if there was any issues with the operator. Was he driving too fast or too slow? The third being is we want to look at what were the soil conditions at planting and following planting to see if we were maybe too cold, too dry, too wet. The fourth reason being is that we're looking to see if there was biotic issues such as insects and diseases that cut back our emergence populations. And then the fifth reason is that we're really looking at crop performance going into the future. So was there something that we might need to continually watch throughout the growing season, and then will it help us get an idea of even what yield potential is this early in the season? So I'd really encourage doing stand assessments early in the year. You can do them as early as emergence, but a lot of times it is easier to do these assessments when you're at the first, second, or even the third leaf stages. The first part of doing a stand assessment is understanding and counting how many plants per acre we have, or doing stand counts. So the process to do this is identifying the row spacing, which in this case we're in a cornfield that was planted on 30-inch rows. And then because of the 30-inch rows, I know that I need to count a row length of 17 feet 5 inches. By counting 17 feet 5 inches, I know that that is 1/1000th of an acre. And so I can basically do the counts and then multiply by 1,000 to know how many plants per acre, or estimate how many plants per acre we have. So to speed this along a little bit, what I've done here currently is I've laid out a tape measure to 17 feet 5 inches, and I've put orange stakes at the beginning and the end of that row length. And so then it's just a matter of counting how many plants are in that row length. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 17, 18, 19. Okay, so we had 19 plants in that 17 feet 5 inches, and so that equates out to 19,000 plants per acre. So when we do these stand assessments, usually for a given area, I'll do both sides of the row spacing that I'm walking in. So I got two, and then I'm averaging those together. And then for a field, I'm trying to do this again about once, getting a good assessment once every 10 acres or so. The second part of doing a stand assessment is looking at emergence uniformity. So there's two aspects to looking at uniformity. The first is how evenly spaced the plants are within that row length. And then the second part of that is looking at how well did they emerge over time. So did they all emerge within 5 to 12 hours, or did they emerge over the course of 5 to 10 days? And so as we do that, what I've done here is I've just laid out 17 feet 5 inches of row length, so 1/1000th of an acre. And then in that row length, I've already counted and know that I have 29,000 plants per acre in that area or that assessment. So the first thing that I'm looking at is just the spacing of the plants. So I can see that initially here, you know, we've got plants that are spaced out about 5 to 6 inches apart, which would be pretty common. I can see initially here that our first plant is a little bit shorter than our second and our third plants. That indicates that maybe it emerged a little bit later. So we might be at roughly a half stage difference in those first couple of plants. But then as I continue down the row, what I see is a little bit wider spacing here. So not quite a foot, but we're looking at roughly 9 inches. And then I have two plants together. And so what this could be is that it could be two seeds that drop together, or it could be a seed that rolled down the furrow and ended up next to another seed to get that double that we have there. And then as I continue down, I have a stretch here with no plants. Again, that could be that we just didn't have any seed drop, or that we had seeds that dropped and then they just did not germinate and emerge. And then as we continue, we have a shorter plant, a little bit taller plants here. And then we get into a section of row about a foot and a half to 2 feet where we don't have any plants again at all. And so this would be a really good area to open up that furrow and see if we had seed drop or if the seeds germinated and died before they emerged. One thing that we can see in this difference just from the surface is that we do have some residue that was pinched into that seed furrow, which is maybe not something that we would want to have happening if the row cleaners on the planter were functioning properly. They would have shoved that out of the way. As we continue down the row, we see a nice set of evenly spaced plants, and again, a set of doubles here where we have two plants together. And then a couple plants that were maybe a little bit further behind, so maybe a half stage behind as far as the emergence and the staging that we have here. And so we can continue down, and we want to really do those types of assessments, looking at do we have stage differences or differences in emergence dates, and then looking, do we have doubles, misses, or rolls as we look at the spacing through that seed furrow. The third step of doing a stand assessment is looking at why maybe we don't have emergence or uniformity of emergence the way we'd like. This can include digging open or pulling open that seed furrow, assessing do we have sidewall compaction or not, and then assessing if what we have for seed depth or seed placement. So I like to use a flat bottom spade like this. Other people use trowels or other different tools. I like this because when I place it, I can take that seed furrow right there and I can go about 2 to 3 inches off of that seed furrow. If I firmly step that spade down in, my goal here is to go down about 3 inches. Then I should be able to slowly pull that spade backwards. Sometimes you do have to help it a little bit so we know what we got going on. So in this case, I was able to pop open that seed furrow and move some of that residue there. This was a space where we did not have a seed emerge or a plant up anyhow. And so what I can see right away is I can actually see that seed there. It was a seed drop, but it is less than an inch there. It's probably 3/4 of an inch to an inch deep. But it also is not all the way down to the bottom of that seed furrow, which is about 1 3/4 to 2 inches. So for whatever reason, that seed was not firmly placed down into the bottom of the seed furrow and did not germinate and emerge there. As I pick up that seed, we do have a little bit of a radical root. The seed is still firm. So in this case, what may have happened, and there you can see the shoot on the other side of it. So what may have happened there is that it just was too dry as high up as it was placed and just did not have a good chance to germinate and get out of the ground as evenly as the rest of the plants in this row. So here at another spot, I'm just going to pull that residue away so I can see my seed furrow. I'm going to place my spade about 3 inches away, step it down about 3 inches deep, and then slowly pull back on the spade to pop open the seed furrow. So that was a pretty good opening here. I'll just move that away. So here we actually do have a plant that is maybe a day away from emerging. If we look at seed depth on it, and this one here to the bottom of the seed is about 1.5 inches. Top of seed maybe 1.25 inches or so. And so when as we look at that, it was a miss in the row, but there's a seed that for some reason just germinated later and is going to emerge later than the rest of that row. You can also maybe tell that this is a little bit wetter soil by the earthworms in there and some of that, but it does not show signs of sidewall compaction. So as we think about and as we do stand assessments, identifying why we don't have the stand or why we don't have good uniformity of emergence is a critical component of that, so we can make corrections probably 9 to 12 months later, but still very valid to make sure that we give ourselves that opportunity.